So this one, we need to find out if the currency is going to appreciate or depreciate relative to the currency it's compared to, and by how much over the next year and over the next 5 years. Do you guys know the formula for that? I should put it in here, actually.
Is that versus like spot rate times the USD over what was the?
I think that's that may be forecasting.
Oh, that's right.
Exchange rate.
Yeah, that's like pretty close. You're on the right track there.
This one, I just remember, like, the difference between exchange rates is kind of like the amount that it's going to appreciate or depreciate over time, right? Kind of.
So not the difference between the exchange rates, the difference,
or the difference between inflation rates.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I meant. And then, okay, so that's our formula. And the country with the higher inflation rate is going to depreciate against the currency with
lower
inflation rate. So the Australian dollar, will it appreciate or depreciate against the US dollar?
It'll appreciate.
Okay, by how much over the next year? So what's that formula?
3%.
Okay. And then over the next 5 years?
15.
Yeah, it's just the 1 year times. Okay, perfect. Next one. Real against the US dollar. Is the real going to depreciate or appreciate?
Depreciate.
And over the next 5 years, we just multiply that, right? Okay, last one, Australian dollar against the real. Is the Australian dollar going to appreciate or depreciate?
Appreciate.
Appreciate, exactly. And then in this formula, it says home inflation minus foreign inflation. It doesn't super matter in these calculations as long as you know which one's appreciating and which one's depreciating. I'm just minusing them that so that none of them are negative. That makes sense. The order is not super important. You just have to know if it's appreciating or depreciating. Okay, and then over 3 years, we just multiply that by number of years, right? Okay, any questions there? No. Alright, this is where it starts getting a little bit more tricky. I'm gonna pull up the formula again for this one. Let's try it again. Formula for exchange rate at time t, so spot rate over time. Alright, so using this formula, what inputs are we going to use here for 1 year? Australian dollar per US dollar. We'll start off with the spot rate, right? US dollar per Australian dollar. And 1 plus. Let me make sure I get this right on the first try. Plus home inflation, which is US dollar. I'm actually going to lock these in because I'm going to bring them down to the next one. Over home plus foreign inflation rate, on the power of there. Okay, can you just copy that down if you have those rates locked in? And get it for 5 years. Just, you have these numbers here. Does that help? I realize, like, I've already got all this stuff in my Excel sheet. If you guys need time to put that in, just let me know. So we're going kind of fast, so any time to set it up, that's fine. But if not, okay. So this one, what is our spot exchange rate here? KL for US dollar.
Spot exchange. 2.5.
Yeah. 2.5, I'll lock that in, just to make my life simpler in the long run. Okay, home inflation.
2%.
2% if we're doing the US dollar per real.
So 5, sorry.
Yeah. That's true, we use 2% for US inflation like all the time, but
yeah,
it throws me off. Okay, and then foreign inflation, we're using real. I might have these mixed up actually. Since it's real for US dollar.
Let's see what it looks like.
Yeah, I think we did use some stuff though. See, you had it right on the first one. So in this case, real here, like since it's an indirect quote, you're going to use the real as your home currency. Okay, and you can just copy that down if you have these cells all locked in, you have the years out to the side, and you can get the rate for 5 years. So the next one, the first thing we need to do is figure out what the cross exchange rate is. So for that, I'm just going to do the Brazilian per US dollar exchange rate divided by, and I'll actually do 1 over US dollar per Australian dollar. To get that into an indirect quote. I could probably do it the other way. Let's see. This is just me playing with math. So you can figure out the cross exchange rate, it's 2.8 real per Australian dollar, and then we just do the exact same formula. So spot right here is the cross rate. Okay. see if it's there now. Plug that in. And foreign currency is the Australian dollar in this situation. Power of 20 yen. Copy that. Everything good at this point? Cool, cool, we're rolling. Questions 5 through 7. These ones aren't that bad. They look kind of bad, but I don't know. Let's get it down. It's not super difficult. Okay, so this is what's given here, right? Is our years and our euro cash flows. Is that what it looks like in the quiz? In the work assignment?
Yeah.
Okay. And then these are our assumptions here, as well as the discount rate of 6%. So we've got all those down. The exchange rate. And then we're assuming that's going to remain the same through years 1 through 5. So what we need to find out first off is our U.S. dollar cash flows. So we'll just multiply those together and bring those all the way out, okay? And then, have you guys gone over the NPV function in class?
Okay.
So we're all good on that?
Yeah.
All right, so we're just gonna use our discount rate, cash flows from years 1 through 5, and then we have to add back in our initial output, initial cash flow. Okay, so NPV of $6.64, and the IRR, just highlight all of the US cash flows. Good? All right. And to simplify things, I'm actually gonna just copy that down through the next few problems. So we're just gonna change a few assumptions on each of them. All right, so that's question 5, the NPV is 664, and IRR is 7.9%. Okay, so years 1 through 5, we assume that the exchange rate depreciates. So year 0, it's still the same, nothing changes, but then 1 through 5, it goes to 115. Okay. We change that, and that'll change our NPV to 389, and IRR to 4.8%. So once you have a model in place, these questions are already simple to play with. Like, you just have to change one or two numbers. All right. Question 7, does anyone want to take a stab for that?
I just use like the solver function.
Yeah, you can use solver or goalseek, right?
Yeah.
So you just need to get NPV to 0. What I'll start off with doing is just linking all these cells to year 1. So like if I change year 1, then they all change. Year 0 doesn't change, obviously. So we'll go to NPV, again, like we've already got the model in place from questions 5 and 6. What if analysis, goal seek, I'm going to set NPV to 0 by changing C36 in this case. We're changing the exchange rate in year 1. So, does that work for everyone? Cool. Dang, it's 7:20. We're already through 7 questions.
Keep it moving.
I'm fine with this. Okay. Question eight. So we play with a lot of different assumptions on this one. It's a similar model to questions 5 through 7, but we're just going to make it a little bit more complex. First off, we invest $40,000 US dollars up front to get new equipment. Second off, we're going to sell 220 shirts in Europe every year. So that's year 1 through 5. We've got those in there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, year one prices will be 40 euros per shirt, and that will rise each year with European inflation. So year one, the price is just 40. And then what did it say for inflation? European inflation is 4% each year, US inflation is 2% each year, so we've got those written in this model. So that's these, we just need to do whatever the previous year's price is times 1 plus inflation, right? Copy that across. Oops. Okay. Alright. Now the spot rate. This one gets a little bit tricky. Kind of have to play with it. It's a little bit messed up, but we'll go through it. So the spot rate in year one, like this is what got me announcing this afternoon. It's the spot exchange rate in year zero, but it's also the spot exchange rate in year one, and then you change it after that. So we'll put 1.20, and then it changes every year after that. So I'll use that same formula. So spot exchange rate times 1 plus, okay, home inflation. We're going to use US inflation here. 1 plus euro inflation. Power of, okay, this is where it got me. We're not going to do the power of 2 since it's just 1 year out. So the power of 1, so 1 year out. Then we can copy that across and we should be in good shape. Good to that point? Cool. Alright, so our European cash flows. That doesn't really matter. It won't really worry about your cash flows in year zero, but you can put them in anyway. And after that, it's just however many shirts you sell times the price per shirt, right? Okay. So we've got our European cash flows, and then we just need to switch those over to US dollar. It's pretty simple. So euro times the spot rate in that year. We got it at that point. We know what our euro revenues in year 5 are. We know what our USD revenues in year 5 are. Just figure out NPV. Discount rate at 10%. Our US cash flows. And then add in our expenditure. IRR is just all of the US cash flows. Okay. Everyone happy?
Like what we all did today, so.
Cool.
That's pretty fresh.
We're just reviewing. All right. Question 9. It's the same in theory. I'm just going to copy this over, actually. Might have to change a couple of things because their cells are locked in. But yeah. So the only thing that changes this is European inflation. Just snap that over. When you look at the outlook for the project, this only changes the European revenues. Everything else stays the same.